Hello everyone, what is cooking all you good looking people out there, and welcome to another exciting episode of Universe Sandbox 2. Today we are going to check out some of the other features of this game, and we are going to try and terraform Mars, because we can do it. It's been, I know that it's possible, I just don't really know. Oh, okay, so in this version of it, we may have CO2 that we can do, climate, greenhouse effects, atmosphere pressure, surface temperature, enable climate, sure, on, there you go, enable climate on, advanced, land ocean, show atmosphere, show clouds, heat capacity of air. Wow, there's some crazy stuff going on here that I don't really know. Surface temperature is going to be 20 degrees Celsius. Nope. Okay, fine. Surface temperature is going to be 20 degrees Celsius. Boom. And it just immediately drops. All right. Where in the world does one actually add in? Where in the world does one actually? Okay, so organics we can make bigger. We can make that more organics. Sort of 2%. Let's make it like, okay, a little bit less, you know, actually, okay, let's go zero, let's make it maybe, you know, just a few fractions, some organics, water, we can go and add, let's go, come on, let's get the surface a little bit watery, that looks good to me, so organics has to go down even less than that, and that's water, so organics is going to be maybe something like this. Hydrogen. No, that's going to stay to none. Greenhouse effect. I don't know how to change that. I really wish I did. Climate. Heat capacity of air is much higher. Surface temperature is going to be 20 degrees Celsius. Boom. But it goes all the way down. Greenhouse effect. There's no way for me to actually do that. How do you add CO2 to a planet? I know there's a way of doing it, but I just don't know how one does it at all. That's the sad part. There is a way to do it. I don't know how. Damn it. It's really not in climate. One would think it is. And you can't actually just change this. Atmosphere mass. You can make the atmosphere mass more. All right, there you go. Atmosphere is going up and up. Do we have any idea what the atmosphere is made out of? Not really, but we'll make the atmosphere go up. Maybe the temperature is going to go up because of it. Okay, things are going quite good. 15, yeah, 15 is seems like an okay number. It's only at 60. Heat capacity of air. Okay, we can change that up. All right, and let's make a bigger atmosphere then. There you go. Come on, more atmosphere. Bigger atmosphere. I don't even know. Like, there you go. One bar. There you go. One bar of atmosphere is what there is on this planet. Is that good? No idea. We're going to heat this up, heat capacity of air, to a hell of a lot more. Something like this. All right, so the coldness doesn't spread nearly as much. Heat capacity of air, this one. Sure, we'll just raise that like crazy. And the temperature then drops down. Land ocean heat. What does that even say? I have no idea. But that keeps dropping down. Materials. There's no materials I can easily place. Density. Simulate radius. Nothing there. Is there hydrogen gas? That heats up the planet a little bit. I mean, it kind of goes, no. Okay, we don't want to do that. That just looks crazy. In anything in here that we could do, surface temperature, I mean, the surface temperature did at least go up, so we're going to have to change things quite drastically. All right, fine. Is there any way to make this, I don't know, sort of like 15,000? Okay, there you go. Heat capacity of air. I don't know. That's going to be 9,000. Okay, things drop substantially less. We're going to go into bar, and we're going to make this 3 bars of pressure. And this is what we experience there. And the atmosphere mass is drastically higher. Kilogram, I have no idea. 1. All right, is there any way to increase that? I mean, okay, the numbers are dropping slightly less now. That's good. Although the world is covered in water by a lot. So either the world has now turned like round. I don't know what's happened, but there you go. There's something crazy going on there. Maybe the pressure of the planet has like turned it into, I have no idea. Maybe the pressure of the world has turned it into, like, what is the climate on here? It's just -1 globally. All right, so this is going to be 20,000. Okay, and then that can be, I don't know, 30,000. Maybe we should click on Earth and find out what its numbers are. Well, there you go. That looks good. Temperature is slightly less. Let's go find out what Earth's numbers are. All right, Earth, where are you? You're here. Okay, what are your weird climate numbers? Oh, greenhouse gases. Is there no way for me to add them into there? Advanced. Okay, no. I need 2001 of 2010 level. See, that's what I need. I need to add some greenhouse gases to Mars, but I am unable to for whatever reason. I wish I could. I wish that I could just add them. Add. Oh, maybe it's in powers? Powers. Shoot body. All right. Well, let's see what we can do with powers. Let's zoom back onto you. Dispenser. I don't know what that does. Shoot body. Force. Exploder. Oh. All right. Exploder. Well, there you go. We've done that. Exploder. Woo! Well, this is wild, isn't it? No sun. Okay, well, we've exploded that. That was interesting. I'm just flying into nothing. Let's open. Let's see what other kind of systems we can open here. Exoplanets, supernovas, we already saw that. Experiments, human scale, human size object. Oh, bowling ball. Okay, a bowling ball and a teapot there. So what if I do force? Powers, force. I have no idea what that means. Shoot body. Yes, I'd like to shoot the body. I literally have no idea. OMG, it's full of stars. Okay. I don't know what that even means, but sure, let's exploder that thing. Well, there you go. Something might have happened if we just explode these things. All right, that was just that. The powers are weird. I have no idea what they even do. Let's go home and let's open experiments. No, I don't want to stress test. Tidal evolution test 2. Oh, so we can now see how something becomes tidally locked. Well, there you go. All right. Well, I mean, I'm sure it works, but do we have like a rotation? Where is the motion? Rotational period is now, oh, okay, it's going down and down and down. We can go and graph this. So the rotational period goes down and down, and there's this thing over here. Oh my goodness. Okay, we'll move the graph, even though it's just, see, it plunges, and there you go. Oh. Actually, I don't know what even happened. I think Jupiter might be in contact with the sun. It seems like it somehow... Seems like it somehow aligned itself. I mean, it's pretty tightly locked now, but that's just weird. Galaxy collision, moon 75 orbiting Earth. Wow, that they immediately just crash into each other, don't they? I mean, that's just crazy. The Earth is for whatever reason rising in this scenario, which admittedly is a bit bizarre. I mean, of course, when you have 75 moons, you know, what's going to happen? Planet's just going to crash into itself. That's kind of crazy. Wow. Would you look at that? Oh, the Earth has been hit. Goodbye. I wonder if... Oh, yeah, I wanted to see the surface damaging of a comet hitting the Earth. So we could do that. We could bombard it, and then that would lower the green. Okay, home. Let's go planet, or let's. Is it in that? No. Is it in? It's not in edit. It's in home. Is edit? No, it doesn't really do anything. Home. I want to see collisions. Main, create, encounters. Or is it in collisions? Yeah, collision. Just Earth and a big asteroid. Is that really big enough to create? No. Let's go in there. Earth and a lot of things. Earth and a bunch of fixed time step. I mean, you can see. Can you really see the impact? It's pretty hard to tell. Earth and moon, asteroid. Okay. Asteroid that and asteroid 50. Asteroid. I want Earth and like a ton of asteroids or something like that. I mean, you can kind of see the impact markers, but you barely do, which is the part that's too bad. All right. Earth. Sure. Earth in this thing. Wow. I barely even. All right. Home. Earth. Sure. Earth in series. That'll be better. So, boom. All right. That's a big impact. So, first, what we do have to do is rotational period days one. There you go. So, first, the Earth has to rotate. And there you go. So the Earth is rotating, which is quite nice. And then eventually we're going to have to get it out of there. Climate, it is going to go crazy. Greenhouse gases is probably going to go down or something, or maybe not. But you can definitely see, all right, there you go. Big impact right there, which is nice. So now the climate. I want to know if there's anything that dropped, any numbers that have gone down like crazy. Surface pressure. Alright, well, we get to see the actual impact markers that this is left on the planet. The Earth's temperature has gone... The Earth's temperature has gone up quite a bit. It's going to cause some real issues. So we can speed things up like this. See what happens. I want to look into climate and see how Earth is being affected. Enable climate is on. If I off the climate, okay. Turning climate on, things are quite different. Turning climate off, the planet quickly devolves into madness. But over here, seems like the Earth relatively stable. Although it is 113 degrees Celsius, so it makes it much more stable to keep the climate on. That's an interesting idea. But wow, look at this. You can see that the oceans are partially drying up. Well, that's interesting. Well, there you, oh yeah, look at this. Looks like now Japan and China are connected to each other. You can see, oh wow, look at that. You can even see there's depth there. All right, let's just go look by as things. You can see big impact craters. Maybe that's just the water level that receded because it went in to fill those big giant holes. Okay, so let's go and should we add more water? Let's turn the greenhouse gas levels to, I don't know, maybe 5 times 2010 levels and see what happens here. Does anything happen? No, heat, air, of atmosphere, mass, basic. I don't really know, but maybe, okay, I think the poles have already completely melted, but it really, the water levels have gone down quite drastically, most likely due to giant holes that needed to be get filled by the impact. Let's simulate that impact one more time. There, all right, and we want a rotational period, day one. There you go. Very nice, right there. And boom. Oh, wow, look at that. Now that is a big impact. And you can see, oh, wow, okay, so this is quite saturated. You can see initially it looks like the water levels rise quite drastically, actually. We can go into climate and see the things go kind of crazy. But actually, now the water levels start decreasing, so there's giant flooding that happens, but now the water levels drastically start pulling back. Okay, well, what if we started alleviating this issue by adding a little bit more water on Earth? Maybe what we could do is just sort of drown out this giant crater by adding in more water. I mean, that would work, wouldn't it? Not really, but, you know, there you go. The water levels, I don't know if they've really risen. Well, there you go. Big impact zone. Go down. Go look here. And sure, let's add more water. All right, a little bit less water. A little bit. Oh, it looks like that amount of water has pretty much balanced things out. Things are a bit different nowadays, but there's more water on Earth, and that's fine. Let's add more organics. What if we just go crazy with organics? What happens? I think the Earth has gotten bigger. Oh, wow. The Earth is now some kind of giant living organic compound. I don't know what that does, but is it? As it turns out, there's not enough water for this. And hydrogen? Oh, God. You don't want to add hydrogen. Hydrogen goes kind of crazy, doesn't it? Oh, hydrogen has messed things up a little bit. Let's go take that down. No, zero, please. Okay, no more hydrogen. That was a bad idea. Climate is now 116 degrees Celsius somehow. Things look like they're melting after the hydrogen outpouring, which was a very bad idea. It's like the oceans didn't freeze. Now everything is just covered in a weird layer of white. Wow. What a weird planet this is. Also, it's like infinite hot, but that's fine. Well, I think I'm going to call it here. This game is really cool. Really cool simulation. A great idea to follow this. I think it's like $26 right now if you guys are interested in getting it. There's a lot to do. If you have the first one, maybe wait till the full release of this game. That way you get to experience all the new features. But if you're really excited, if you, you know, played a lot of the first one and you really like it and you want to get something new, something fresh, $25 is a great price. It's definitely a great price for the full finished product. This is an alpha, as you can see, alpha 14.A. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed. And as always, wow, you can hardly even recognize the world anymore. I will see you guys next time. Aw, yeah. Cue the royalty-free music. 3, 2, 1, go. Come on, everybody. Get on your feet. Stand up, look at the screen, and repeat. I'm gonna like, rate, comment, and subscribe. I love watching Athervids all of the time. Thanks for dropping by and spending the time. Hope you've enjoyed, and let's get on with our lives. Oh yeah. Thanks to Kevin McLeod for these awesome beats. Ooh yeah. Have a good one.